Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsline and have the top stories we are tracking for you on Friday, the 9th of August. India says awaiting release of 69 Indian citizens from Russian army. Yunus takes charge of Bangladesh, hopes to heal strife-torn country. And villagers in Gilgit-Baltistan fear imminent land erosion, lament inaction. And now for all the details. India's Foreign Minister S. Jaishankar, responding to a question on Indian nationals in the Russian army, informed the parliament that 91 Indians were recruited, of which 14 have been discharged and 69 are awaiting release. The minister said that there are reasons to indicate that the recruited Indian nationals were misled on false promises and added that the issue is being taken very seriously by the government. Jaishankar asserted that both Prime Minister Narendra Modi and he himself had personally raised these issues with Russia's Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov and President Vladimir Putin during their visit to Moscow last month. Notably, several Indians were allegedly duped into fighting in Russia's war with Ukraine on the pretext of lucrative jobs. India on Thursday added two medals to their tally at the Paris Olympics after India's ace javelin thrower Neeraj Chopra and India's field hockey team finished at second and third positions in their respective events. In an electrifying match, India beat Spain 2-1 to win bronze in men's hockey, with skipper Harmanpreet Singh scoring two goals to put his side in front after they fell behind in a tournament where his heroics proved decisive in all of their wins. The win gave India its second consecutive bronze medal as part of 13 medal haul for the once dominant side that won gold for six games in a row from 1928 to 1956.
ब्रॉन्ज मेडल जीतना आई थिंक ये हिस्ट्री है हमारे लिए और हॉकी के लिए बहुत बड़ी बात है. हम यहाँ आए थे गोल्ड के लिए और जैसे हमने लोगों को दिखाया कि हॉकी में इंडिया टीम बेस्ट है और अपना अच्छा परफॉर्म कर रही है. आई थिंक हम बहुत क्लोज थे बट हम और ज़्यादा डिजर्व करते थे, बट ये जर्नी है, यहीं से अब हम सीखते हैं और ये सीख हमें आगे जाके बहुत हेल्पफुल रहेगी. बट वी आर सो प्राउड कि हमने ये ब्रॉन्ज मेडल जीता.
Meanwhile, India's ace athlete Neeraj Chopra, competing in Olympic men's javelin, secured the second spot, securing the silver medal with a throw of 89.45. He was beaten by Pakistan's Arshad Nadeem, who won the gold with a stunning 92.97 meters throw. Neeraj Chopra has become the second Indian male athlete post-independence to win two Olympic medals in an individual event.
जब भी मेडल जीतते हैं उसकी खुशी तो होती है, लेकिन वही है कि पर्सनली मतलब मेडल की बात अलग है, लेकिन अब टाइम है इम्प्रूवमेंट करने का थ्रो में भी, और जो भी कुछ इंजरी वगैरह है जो चल रही हैं उन पे अभी काम करना है और जो कमियां हैं उनको सुधारेंगे, टीम के साथ बैठ के बात करेंगे. और अच्छा रहा है टोटली, अगर ऑल ओवर देखें तो अपनी इंडिया की परफॉर्मेंस अच्छी रही है.
And after months of violent protests which forced Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina to quit and seek refuge in India, Mohammad Yunus on Thursday took charge of Bangladesh interim government. But as Yunus vows a fresh start, the nation is grappling with a humanitarian crisis, with thousands of Hindus trying to flee their homes amid a wave of violence targeting the minority community. A report.
Mohammad Yunus, Bangladesh's only Nobel laureate, on Thursday took charge of Bangladesh's interim government as the chief advisor of the caretaker government following weeks of violence which forced PM Sheikh Hasina to quit. He is tasked with bringing stability back in the country and then hold fresh parliamentary elections. The brutal autocratic regime is gone, Yunus, an arch foe of Hasina, said in a televised address to the nation after taking charge. Tomorrow, with the rising sun, democracy, justice, human rights and full freedom of fearless expression will be enjoyed by all, regardless of party affiliation. That is our goal, he said. Meanwhile, talking to an Indian daily, Hasina's son Sajib Wazir Joy has said Hasina is likely to return to Bangladesh whenever the interim government calls the fresh elections.
তরুণ প্রজন্ম যেভাবে পরিশ্রম দিয়ে আমাদের দেশটাকে পুনর্জন্মের নিচে এখানে আমরা চাচ্ছি যে সুন্দর সুসংগঠিত একটা বাংলাদেশ প্রত্যাশা করতেছি তার কাছে। এটা হচ্ছে শর্টলি একটা মেসেজ।
বর্তমান অন্তর্বর্তীকালীন সরকারের কাছে আমার আবেদন এবং নিবেদন থাকবে, অপরাজনীতি অপসংস্কৃতিকে বন্ধ করে যার আগামী দিনের আমরা সুন্দর চলতে পারি, নিম্নবিত্ত মধ্যবিত্ত লোকেরা যারা দুবেলা দুমুঠো ভাত সুন্দরভাবে খেতে পারি, সুন্দরভাবে রাস্তায় চলতে পারি।
Meanwhile, hundreds of Bangladeshi Hindus have reportedly tried unsuccessfully to flee to India this week after many homes and businesses of the minority community were vandalized following Hasina's ouster. Hindus make up about 8% of Muslim majority Bangladesh's 170 million people and have traditionally supported Hasina's Awami League party, which identifies as largely secular. Neighboring India has raised concern about the attacks. India's Prime Minister Narendra Modi, who congratulated the interim government head Yunus for assuming the charge, has also urged an early return to normalcy and said India hopes they ensure the safety and protection of Hindus and all other minority communities.
Moving on, villagers in parts of Gilgit-Baltistan are facing an imminent threat of land erosion due to the rapid melting of glaciers and overflowing rivers. The lack of action from local authorities have left residents in Hunza in distress.
Residents in parts of the Hunza district of Pakistan-occupied Gilgit-Baltistan are increasingly concerned about the imminent land erosion threat posed by melting glaciers in Passu and the subsequent overflow of rivers. They lament the administration has yet to take measures to mitigate the effects of climate change. The rivers have expanded, destroying homes, farms and vital infrastructure. The farming community in particular has been severely impacted. The residents are demanding compensation for their losses. One local resident expressed sorrow over the destruction, stating that all their belongings had been swept away by the rivers.
Community apni madad aapke tehat kaam kar chuke hai. Mere khayal se in tamam tabahi ka zimmedar hukumat ul waqt hai aur zarurat is baat ki inke tamam جو نقصانات کا ازالہ ہو جتنے نقصانات ہیں ان کی ان کو ازالہ ہو اور مستقبل میں اس گاؤں کے جو 90% اس وقت دریابود ہو چکا ہے اس 10% کو بچانے کے لیے خدا اور رسول کے واسطے بند لگائیں
اور یہاں کوئی بھی آبی انتظام نہیں نہ اوپر سے راستہ ہے نہ نیچے سے راستہ ہے ہمارا خوردنی اشیاء ہمارے کو ضروریات کا سامان اور تمام چیزیں ہم یہاں پھنسے ہوئے ہیں اور کوئی بھی ادارہ کا یا گورنمنٹ کا ہم ریکویسٹ کرتے کہ بلائی مہربانی کر جلد از جلد اس کو بحال کی جائے
Despite the pleas by villagers, the lack of governmental intervention continues to leave these communities vulnerable to the devastating effects of climate change. As the crisis worsens, residents fear that their homes and livelihoods may soon be completely wiped out with no relief in sight. The urgent need for government action to protect these at-risk areas cannot be overstated.
And the Taliban has said that xenophobia and the violation of the human rights of Afghan migrants in other countries are unacceptable. The remarks come amid a video surfacing over social media of Iran police mistreating an Afghan teenager. Key Taliban leader Anas Haqqani expressed hope that this type of behavior will be stopped and said those responsible should be held accountable. In recent days, several instances of mistreatment of Afghan migrants has come to light. Some Afghan migrants in Iran have reportedly been harassed by Iranian citizens and police in recent weeks. This comes as Iran has said that unauthorized migrants must leave the country by the end of this year. And in a landmark move, a parliamentary committee has ordered the Nepal government to form an independent inquiry to probe the country's overall air safety standards. According to a report by the Kathmandu Post, Parliament's International Relations and Tourism Committee said the inquiry commission will submit the report in 2 weeks and should also recommend action against those found guilty, particularly in connection with the recent plane crashes. The order comes after 2 air crashes were reported in the Himalayan nation, which killed at least 23 people, including 5 foreign nationals. The two air accidents in 2 weeks have dented the country's image. We need to find a way to prevent future accidents and bring officials responsible for such utter negligence to justice. The Kathmandu Post quoted Parliamentary Committee Chairman Raj Kishore Yadav as saying, Nepal has been criticized for its poor air safety record, with more than 100 crashes happening in 7 decades of the country's aviation history. Many airlines fly to small airports in remote hills and near peaks shrouded in clouds. The country's main airport is also ringed by mountains, affecting wind direction and intensity and making takeoff and landing a challenge for pilots. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time next week. Have a great weekend. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.